What do you want to do tonight, Edie?
You want to watch a little TV?
Nah, we did that last night.
Oh, yeah. Got any other ideas?
Can listen to some music, see what's on the turntable.
That's a good idea. Let's see what we got.
I like it.
Yeah, kind of catchy.
Well, I loved your music when I heard it, and I was surprised that you could do that so well because you do so many other things.
Well, I was surprised that you liked it. I think of you as a sophisticate.
Uh-huh. Well, then when you said you had a tune with no song to it yet, I couldn't wait to hear it. I was so thrilled that you kept sending tunes to me because they would arrive and there were little stories in them just immediately for me. I saw a lot of images and all I had to do was sit back and narrate what I saw. All of the opening lines come straight out of the banjo. The mood that Steve sets is so powerful that all I had to do was trust what I heard and how it made me feel. And then just start singing. And there it was. They were like, the songs were just gifts straight from the banjo melody. Love has come for you.
Love. When the song comes back to me, I hear the line, love has come for you. And I think that is such an unusual way to phrase something, because usually someone would say, love has come to you. Love has come for you is this double entendre. It is either come, meaning it has come for you as a blessing, or it has come for to take you. It's come to get you. And I just thought it was such a beautiful, poetic way to phrase something. I was just knocked out. That was like our third song, I think.
Sit right there, Edie. Don't move. Let's see, just kind of come in. Steve, come to the other side. Yep. Love has come.
Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Asher, bring him a chair. Oh, that is a chair. Okay.
Thank you.
The producer of our record, Mr. Peter Asher.
Entirely unexpected, came out of a dinner party at your house.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. When Steve played me some of the stuff, and I mean, I already was a great admirer of Steve's banjo playing and the music he writes, but
that I find hard to believe. But anyway, it sounds good on the interview.
But this came as a surprise, and as he explained the process to me, I was fascinated by it, and then got to watch some of the process in action.
It's not a bluegrass record in the sense that if it was a bluegrass record, it would be performed by a bluegrass band. And those five instruments would define the music. I really like the way it sounds. It almost sounds more like a string quartet or something is going on. My own agent called me up and he said, Steve, I hope this doesn't insult you, but this is the best thing you've ever done.
That damn collar of yours. I knew I should have called you last night and told you about that. Sorry, my fault. Show me when you're
gonna come back. Who is that? They're good.
They're great.
Yeah. Let's listen to another one. What's it gonna be when the enemy, when it tries to get in your head? It's a long, lonely night when you tell him no, and you tell him go, and he shows you pictures instead.